हेलो वन एंड ऑल, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ए टॉपिक कॉल्ड असिम्प्टोटिक नोटेशन। इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी डिस्कस अबाउट बिग ओ नोटेशन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अनदर टू नोटेशन, दैट इज बिग ओमेगा एंड बिग थीटा। बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ए बिग ओमेगा बिग थीटा, लेट्स discuss about what is the meaning of big O. Big O, it is also called as an upper bound, and big omega, it is also called as a lower bound, and finally big theta, it is an average bound. In previous session we discussed about all those things. Today I am going to tell about big omega. Big omega, big omega symbol we write as omega. Before going to start a big omega, let's discuss about the definition of big omega. Before that, I will write on some expression. 1 less than log n, less than root n, less than root n, less than less than n, less than n log n, less than n square, less than n cube, and so on. This is the expression for all the asymptotic notation, three asymptotic notation. Yes, before going to start an example of big omega, let's discuss about the definition of big omega. First, the function f of n is equal to omega g of n, omega of g of n, if and only if there exist positive constant c and positive integer n naught, such that this is very important, f of n greater than or equal to c into g of n for all n is greater than or equal to n naught. What is the difference between big O and big omega? In big O we written f of n is less than c into g of n, but in big omega we written as f of n is greater than or equal to c into g of n for all n greater than n naught. I will repeat again the definition. Let f of n be the time complexity of an algorithm. The function f of n is said to be a omega g of n, such that c and n naught is a positive constant, such that f of n is greater than or equal to c into g of n for all n greater than or equal to n naught. This is the definition of big omega. I will explain one small example. We'll take one example. F of n indicates 2n plus 3. F of n should be taken as a one example, 2n plus 3. Now, what is the value of f of n? 2n plus 3 greater than or equal to c into g of n, right? Now 2n plus 3 greater than or equal to, I will take one example, c into g of n indicated as, assume 1n, it is a 1 into n. Now 2n plus 3 is greater than 1n, right? Yes, that is n is greater than or equal to 1. It says that n is greater than or equal to n. Now 2n plus 3, that is f of n, it is called as an f of n. This is f of n. What is 1? 1 indicates c. What is g of n? This is n, indicates g of n. Finally, f of n is equal to omega of n, because here n indicates this is a omega of n. If, for example, I will take 2n plus 3 greater than or equal to, instead of 1n, I will take log n. This is also true. So f of n indicates log n. We can write this is also. This is also correct. How? See here. This is this after n. This is upper bound. This is average bound. This is lower bound. In previous session, I discussed about this is a in between. Middle is an average bound. This is lower bound and upper bound. If you go beyond this, this is a lower bound. So we can use a big omega is a lower bound. So we can write it as a n log n or one. We can indicate whatever you want. So this is the one of the method of big omega. I will show by using a graph. I will take a small graph to show how omega works. Big omega. See here. This is n. Now, it does not matter. This does not matter. Doesn't matter. Now, this indicates this is f of n. Now, the lower bound indicates we have to start from here. And here, this is C into G of N, that is lower bound. Finally, we can write as F of N is equal, greater than or equal to C into G of N for all N greater than or equal to N naught. This is the main explanation about big omega concept. Now I will explain another one concept, that is big theta. Big theta. Big theta. Before going to show the big theta, let's discuss about the definition of big theta. See here, the function f of n, the function f of n is equal to theta of g of n if and only if there exist positive constant C1. Here in big theta we are using three conditions. In big omega and big O we are discussing only one condition, or that is C into G of N, but here we are using a two condition in between because it is an average bound. It can be taken as a lower bound as well as a upper bound. So in between average bound, so we have to use lower bound also, and also we have to use upper bound also, that is C1 comma C2 and N naught. Clear? Such that C1 into G of N less than or equal to F of N less than or equal to C into G of N. This is the condition, main definition. Yes, I will repeat again the definition. Let F of N be the time complexity of an algorithm. The function F of N is said to be big theta of G of N, that is denoted as F of N for all theta into G of N. If and only if there exist some positive constant, that is C1, C2 and a positive or non-negative integer satisfying, that is n naught, such that C1 into G of N is less than or equal to F of N less than or equal to C2 into G of N for all n greater than or equal to n naught. This is the main definition of big theta. I will take one small example. Let's take one example. Example f of n is equal to 2n plus 3. Now, I will take assume C1 first condition C1 into G of n. Assume C1 into G of n is 1 into n less than or equal to what is the value of f of n for this 2n plus 3 less than or equal to C2 into G. Assume C2 into G of n is 5 into n. See here 1n less than 2n plus 3. This condition is also true. 2n plus 3. Now we take this also. 2n plus 3 less than 5n. 3 plus 2, 5. 5n is less than or equal to 5 into 1, 5. So this condition is correct. So that is n is greater than or equal to n naught. It condition satisfied. That is f of n is average of n only. In previous discussion, I told about 1 less than log n less than root n, less than n log n, less than n square, less than n cube, so on. So what is the average bound? N only. So this indicates n, theta of n only will get the value of n only. So finally f of n is equal to theta of n. N indicates the average bound. We'll discuss a graph of theta. How to write a graph of theta similar to a big O and big theta only we have to write here. But we are using a three graphs. One is f of n in between and lower bound and upper bound we have to use. Clear? This is the graph. N. It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Now this is n naught. This is f of n. Now we'll take this is C1 into G of n. C1 into G of n means lower bound. This is C2 into G of n means this is upper bound. So finally, what do you say? F of n indicates C1 into G of n less than or equal to F of n less than or equal to C2 into G of n. So these are the topics discussed about today's class. So one is big theta, one is big omega, and previous session we discussed about the big O. These three asymptotic notation is very very important question for examination point of view and also for some competitive exam. In next session we discuss about the some example related to asymptotic notation and later we'll go on to best case, worst case and average case. So these are all for the today's class. If you have any doubts regarding this concept, please message me in a comment box. So this is very important question. Please listen this video correctly, and if you have any clarification regarding this topic, please message me in the comment box. Thank you one and all for listening this video. Please subscribe my channel for more updates. Thank you one and all.